Hi.
Hi.
Hey, how are you? Very well, thank you. How about yourself?
I am amazing. Just wanted to ask you, it's almost going to be 3 months in the lockdown.
People, you can't be sitting at home forever. Work has to start. Economy has already been hit hard. Also, people who have older people at home and who have pre-existing conditions like kidney problems, lungs, or their diabetes, they have to really, really be careful. Other than that, by chance, if God forbid, it's such an infectious virus, if you get it, follow your quarantine procedures and it'll go, because the mortality rate isn't high. But the ones that are more prone to it being more intense are older people and pre-consisting condition all along. Other than that, the world is going to go on. Nothing's going to stop the human race from moving on.
Absolutely. Now talking about Arya, the trailer looks fab and, you know, we can't wait to watch it. How was it? How has Joni, you know, been filming this and spending time with Sushmita ma'am and Chandrakant sir? How has it been?
You know, for any actor to work with Ram Madhvani, I think is any way any actor would want to work with him as a maker. For me, I'm just really lucky that I got a chance to spend some time with a human being like Ram. Because more than anything else, career and all these things are small things in the large scheme of life. And the kind of human being that he is, the kind of energy that he has, that is why I don't know who all you must have spoken to, but it was just the most joyous, comfortable and amazing experience of a lifetime to be on a project with that kind of energy. So it was beautiful.
I'm sure this was shot obviously before this coronavirus landed up here. So yeah. Apart from Arya, did you shoot for anything else that, you know, we can expect in the coming days?
There's another series that I still have some work left to be done. That will happen whenever they start shooting. Other than no, it was just this. Suryavanshi was complete. Suryavanshi, they'll release when they have to release. Magi bas, that's all.
So we're not asking about Suryavanshi, but I on this note, I really wanted to ask you that there are some films that are, you know, releasing on the OTT platforms because theaters are shut. So how do you take it as? Because obviously, due to it being on OTT platforms, there's a mass audience that can, you know, see the film. But theater hota hai, jaise kehte hain. So aap kaise dekhte ho is cheez ko?
It's like going to a circus, it's like going for an outing, it's like going for dinner, it's like going, you know, let's go to an amusement park. That's what a theater is. There's always romance and the movies is always associated with the theater. Then these platforms came, that all these other kinds of platforms, Hotstar has come up, you know, all these kinds. Where now you can watch great content right here. Theater is an experience. Theater is cinema and it's got its own flavor to it. You know, we work so that people can watch. So, no matter what the situation is, the main thing is we'll always hope the thing that we do gets a release. So, jahan pe bhi release ho, maybe that was the journey of that and that's cool. Just as long as it releases, I think most people will just be happy.
So, sir, tell me, when it comes to having a political view, do you have the same ideology as your mom and dad, or do you have a different set of thought process?
I don't know. What are the ideologies of my mother?
Like, I don't know if I'm supposed to say it, but we've heard that, you know, Kiran Man and Anupam Sir, they follow BJP and stuff. So, do you have the same ideology?
They are two different people.
No political questions.
No, it's okay. They are two different people and they have two different ideologies. I can tell you that also because I know them personally. So, he has a different political view.
Right.
He has a different political view herself. And I have my own view. They don't have it. So this misconception that you have, do you have the political ideology that your parents have? I mean, you cannot know what my parents have because I myself know that they both have two different things altogether. A third person will have a different thing. They don't have the same thing. nobody follows anything blindly. Other than that, whoever does well for the country, anyway, it's tough, in these positions. I don't follow it. When I do have a lot of knowledge, then I can back it up with something. But just to answer your question, my parents both have different ideologies. They don't have the same ideology. No, that's fine. That's fine. Okay. People will presume or assume. Okay. I just thought because you assumed, I'll just clear it up. That just because two people, they don't have the same ideology. This is different points of view. Like I talk to my mother about stuff. The conversation will be completely different with her. And the conversation with him will be completely different. So you can make out dono ka to same hai nahi.
Sir, talking about Bollywood has been having has been seeing a lot of really gem of an actor like Rishi that you worked with in Aurangzeb.
I can't hear you. Sorry, ma'am.
I was talking about Bollywood being really dark day. You know, we've lost really amazing actors like Rishi Ji, Irfan sir. And knowing the fact that you worked with Rishi Ji, so how do you remember?
Yeah. You know that it's really really sad. I've never gotten a chance to ever spend any time with Irfan Khan, but with Jintu Ji, Jintu Uncle, I had amazing times on Orange. One time I got a chance to meet him and work with him. And I had a great time. He's a very outspoken, vivacious, very loving man. And he's honest. So when you come across a Chintu Kapoor, you'll see, na, he'll like, dant dega thoda sa aapko. But वैसे ही लोग होते हैं जो साफ दिल के होते हैं. वैसे ही लोग कर सकते हैं क्योंकि उनको फर्क नहीं पड़ता. मैं बोल रहा हूँ ना. मैं बोल रहा हूँ. उनका दिल साफ था. You have to understand it. He would sometimes say things to me and I started laughing. क्या कर रहे हो आप? And he understood that I understood and I was not going to let him bully me. That was my working experience with him. He was beautiful. He had a really lovely heart. I had not spoken to him. I was, mera unke saath koi baatcheet tha nahi kabhi, other than the work. And I remember a film of mine I released long time back called Tere Bin Laden. On his own, randomly, on Twitter, he tweeted about me. Something lovely. You know, I have grown up here. I know so many people. Nobody's ever done that. On their own. He did it on his own. He saw something, he liked it, and he gave some credit to it. On his own. Not required. So, I know for a fact, behind my back, he said wonderful things about my work and me to my father, because my father was working in New York, and he was also in New York for a really long time. And to other people, other than my family. So, for me, it's... I will miss him. I'm sure people miss him, but it's such a tremendous loss to the entire film industry, such a loss to cinema, and it's such a sad time for him to have gone. Because a man like Rishi Kapoor, when you go and only 20 people can come and pay their respects, look at the time. Streets would have been shut, and it's not for any other reason. It's because other people would want to be there to pay their respect to him. So it's very very unfortunate. Of course, losing anybody is unfortunate. Irfan Khan, what a great actor, you know. The huge losses to the fraternity.
So sir, looking at you, you've been answering everything that I'm asking so kindly, and I'm so happy about that. I would also want to know ki ye crisis ke dauran, ye time jisme hum sab phase hue hain, kind of people are losing their mental peace, and I have read about a couple of suicide cases that have been kind of.
आपकी आवाज बहुत बुरी तरह कट रही है. अपना माइक उतार दो या पास कर दो. हम बोलिए.
Yes, I want to ask you that, you know, in these crises, in these times, there are a couple of cases that are made of, you know, suicide because of mental depression, pressure. How do you take that as, and what advice would you give to people who are going to watch this interview?
See, a mind is a very fragile place and nobody really knows what's going on. What advice? I am nobody to give advice to this, but I can just say that the mind is a vulnerable place. There are times you'll feel low. Some people are prone to depression. It's a normal thing, and it's a very tough thing. And my only thing is that try to speak to somebody, and there'll be only some people who might be able to. And I understand trying to saying that to somebody. Try to speak to somebody. I know in that situation how tough it can be to even find Because you can just be all alone and you think you're completely alone. Somewhere, if you have family around, I'll tell you just at that one point, think about them. Think about the people you leave behind. And try and talk to somebody. It's very important to try and find somebody. And don't try to find necessarily a friend or something. Try to find somebody maybe you don't know. That's why they say go for help to a professional, a therapist, maybe a doctor, because you know those are it's important. It's important. I have been to a psychiatrist. I've visited one. I've been with one for a while. I'm now looking for a therapist that I would want to meet with and talk to, because our lives from child, from where we are and where we come through on our journey, you know, it's very important to be able to take it out. And we cannot necessarily take it out with people we know. You take it out with somebody because it's easier to talk to somebody who has no background about you. So therefore, there is no judgment. But yeah, I just wish everybody over there strength, including myself, because I've also felt low many, many times. And eventually just see and think that, try to see who you might be leaving behind, you know, what they'll feel without you on the planet, you know, your family maybe, or whoever it may be. But yeah, try and find somebody to talk to, and nothing is there permanently. Everything passes, you know, even though however dark and tough it may be, you know, somewhere or the other, somewhere a little bit it will change. It sounds easier to say because this is such a big and deep, and I'm very emotional and connected to a topic like this, but try and find somebody that you can talk to.
Absolutely. And I think that's the best thing. We all need someone to talk to. That's the only solution, you know, we have.
Go to a therapist, go to a doctor. It's the only way. This is not something to be done with friends and family. This conversation is not supposed to be had with friends and family. Go to somebody who does not know you and speak to them. Somebody who knows, somebody who's probably studied it. If you can't afford it, see, I'm saying it coming from a place of an area where I can probably afford paying a fee to a doctor. But I'm sure if you find out and see, there are still NGOs and places that could try. I'm sure there are around for this. It's a very big study. It's a very big thing that is around on this planet. And just look for some place where you can speak it out.
Also, sir, I wanted to ask you, that it's been so many years you're in the film fraternity, so many, and do you feel that, you know, you've got your due recognition till date, or how do you think?
I don't know what due recognition is. Due recognition is a perception that might be different for you. It's different for me. I don't know what it is. For me, it's very simple. For an actor, is the biggest blessing is to be on busy. That's the biggest blessing for an actor, to be busy. As long as I'm on set, I don't know what recognition is. I don't know what an award is, what a gold medal is, what this is, what that is. If somebody I'm walking on the road looks at me and says, "Aap ho na," I was talking to my internet guy the other day, my person who handles my internet. He said, "Arey, aapko maine dekha wo film mein." I said, "Kaun sa wo?" "Wo Raw karke." I said, "Acha, dekha." He said, "Haan. अच्छा किया आपने काम वो उसमें अच्छा किया वो बहुत अच्छा पकड़ा है वो और एकदम वो सब वॉक वगैरह एकदम अच्छा कड़क पकड़ा वो पुलिस वाले दैट मेड मी मोर देन हैप्पी देन एनीथिंग एल्स बस फॉर मी दैट इज मोर देन इनफ कीप माई सेल्फ कीप योर सेल्फ बिजी रिजल्ट इज नॉट इन आवर हैंड्स इट नेवर विल बी कीप मूविंग ऑन कीप वर्किंग मोर इफ यू कैन जस्ट कीप ट्राइंग टू गेट मोर इफ यू कांट कीप ट्राइंग गो आउट आस्क फॉर वर्क रिक्वेस्ट audition, that's it. You don't know what happens. You touch one person, that's good enough, man.
So, last question and I'll wind up. Lastly, what do you expect from Aryan? Describe it in a sentence or two. How would you say?
I can just tell you that it was the greatest experience of working in this profession of my life. It's all thanks to Ram Madhwani and Amita Madhwani, the way they made us all feel, the way they made every single person on the unit feel, everybody. It's easy for actors to say that, but I'm not talking about actors. I'm talking about every single human being on set around them. That's why the energy was like that. We had such a beautiful energy working on it. We really hope that you enjoy watching the show on the 19th. Just see it for the fact that we really enjoyed making it. And I hope when you watch it, you enjoy the show. That's all.
Yeah, absolutely. Because when they say the trailer says it all, and it's quite intriguing. You're waiting to watch and review it. And thank you all. So on that note, thank you so much for speaking to us. Bollywood Double Play. Thank you, sir. It was lucky.
Thank you so much. Thank you. You guys be safe.
Thank you.
Bye.
And you too, sir. Bye.